Welcome students for today's lecture on the design of cantilever retaining wall. Now, in the previous lecture, we have already discussed how the design of retaining wall is done. So, in the previous lecture, we had already designed the stem portion. We had designed with the toe slab. We had designed with the heel slab. And we provided a reinforcement also as per IS 456-2000. Then we also checked the reinforcement and with respect to the diameter of the bars and the spacing. And we checked the retaining wall for the stability calculation, stability against sliding. Then we also designed the shear key. If the shear key is required, shear key is to be designed. If not required, then shear key not to be designed. Now let us just go what are the components in the cantilever beam. So if you see, this is how the cross section was of the cantilever beam was there. So the stem portion, this is the stem portion from here to here. So the top width is 200 mm and the bottom width is 450 mm. Tapering section was provided. Let us see what was the reinforcement for it. Now, initially we dimensioned this, then design of stem took place. Herein we calculated the moment. We got it as 163.66 kN. And for this we calculate the dimension, so we got that 243.5, but we provided a tapering section, that is 450 at bottom and tapering to 200 mm at the top. It is here, so 450 at the bottom and 200 mm at the top. Then we computed the reinforcement according to IS 456 and the clause number G1.1, page number 96. We calculated the area of steel. We calculate the area of steel and we provided the reinforcement. The provided reinforcement was 10 mm diameter bars at 250 mm center to center on both the faces. Next, we computed the stability calculation. Herein we computed the total number of force and total number of moment. Total number of force worked out to be 203.044 and moment worked out to be 325.202 kN. Using this, we found out the eccentricity. So we came across that it is within the limit and hence eccentricity we will use 0.101 meter. Then we computed the maximum and minimum pressure using the eccentricity. We got maximum pressure as 81.35 and minimum as 54, because these pressures will act upwards from the base of the slab. We require, then we computed the pressure distribution diagram. Using this diagram, we designed the toe slab and heel slab, because if you see the cross section here, the toe slab and heel slab will have a upwards effect of the soil present below. Hence we computed and we come across the moment for the heel slab as 69.06 kilonewton meter. Then according to IS 456-2000 G1.1, we computed the area of steel, which was 484 mm square. We provided 12 mm diameter bars, so providing 12 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center to center, as well as distribution bars as 12 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center to center. Then again, using the stability calculation and the pressure distribution diagram, we computed the design of toe slab. So here again we worked out the moment. So moment worked out to be 25.73 kilonewton meter, and the factor moment on the heel slab worked out to be 38.595 kilonewton meter. That is this. Okay, toe slab. So again we computed the area of steel according to IS 456 G1.1 page number 96. So we got a area of steel 275 mm square, and hence we provided the minimum reinforcement, which is 12 mm diameter at 200 mm center to center. Then we checked the cantilever retaining wall for safety against sliding. We computed the factor of safety, which was 1.24. And hence shear key needed to be provided as it is unstable. So we designed a shear key and provided a shear key. After providing a shear key, we again computed the factor of safety, and which worked out to be better, as well as the shear stress worked out to be better within the safe limits. Now is the main component. Now we shall learn the cross section. So This is important, the diagram. This is important diagram. Now, if you see here, just a minute. Now, this is the cross section of the cross section of the cantilever retaining wall, and this is the longitudinal section of the cantilever retaining wall. If you see the diagram here, this is how the cross section is. So the base slab total is 3 meters width and 450 mm depth. The stem is 200 mm at the top, 450 at the bottom. Here the soil is there and here also soil is there. The total dimension height of the total retaining wall from the bottom of the base slab is h is equal to 5.23 meter. From the ground level it is 4 meter. And this is the soil present from the base of the slab, 1.23 meter. Dimension of toe slab is 450 mm depth and 1 meter width. Dimension of heel slab is 1.55 meter width and 450 mm depth. And the height of the stem is 4.78 meter. So this is how the cross section details are there with respect to the dimension. So this is reflected here, you can see. Now providing a reinforcement. As we told, so providing 12 mm diameter, if you see the reinforcement details. So what is reinforcement to be provided in stem? Providing 10 mm diameter bars at 250 mm center to center on both the faces. That means this is the stem portion, and here we are providing the diameter bars, that is reinforcement on both the faces. So this is how it is provided here. So on both the faces we have provided the diameter. So we have increased. So these are the 10 mm diameter bars at 250 mm center to center. So this is how the reinforcement is going, and this reinforcement we have provided as 16 mm diameter at 300 mm center to center. Okay. And at the top we have provided 12 mm diameter at 200 mm center to center. So if you see the stem portion diagram, the reinforcement will start from here and it will go till here into the shear key as well. So this bar which is going straight, which is of 16 mm diameter by 300 mm center to center, and in the middle section it is 16 mm diameter bar at 150 mm center to center. And these are 12 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center center, and here 10 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center. This will reflect here. So this is the longitudinal section, the cut section from of this, that is in this direction. So you can see here the cut section. So from here to here, if you see, so here it is provided 16 mm diameter bars at 150 mm center center. That is this. Now here 16 mm diameter bar at 300 mm center center. This is where this, the spacing between this is 300 mm center center, and these bar which are coming are nothing but 12 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center center, and these bar here coming is 16 mm diameter bars at 150 mm center center. Now let us see for the heel toe slab or a heel slab. So let us see for the heel slab. So for heel slab, you can see here what we arrived at was providing main reinforcement 12 mm diameter center center at 200 mm center center, and providing 12 mm diameter 200 mm distribution. So that means in this portion, in the heel portion, just I will show it to you. In this heel portion, so providing 12 mm diameter pass at 200 mm center center. So if you see the reinforcement here, we have provided 12 mm diameter pass at 200 mm center center. So we are talking only about this heel portion, that is this. So this is whatever you have, this is, these bars are at 12 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center center, as well as these bars are 12 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center center. This is in the cross section of the heel slab. Here if you see, you can see here 12 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center center, as well as here 12 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center center. Next we shall see for the toe slab. So in the design of the toe slab, you can see the design of the toe slab. We have provided a dimension and minimum reinforcement of 12 mm diameter at 200 mm center center. That means here we have provided 12 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center to center. So if you see here, we have provided 12 mm diameter bars at 200 mm center, and this we have provided for the design of shear key. Shear key, you can see again the design part. So shear key, when we provided, so we provided a 16 mm diameter bar. So here also, this is check for safety of shear key. So according to this, we provided 16 mm diameter wires at 140 mm center. So if you see here, we have provided 16 mm diameter bars at 140 mm center in the shear key. The dimension, the toe slab is of width 1 meter here, 1 meter by height 450 mm, which is shown here. This portion will go from here itself, so 450 mm as it is, shear key 450 mm width, 450 mm height. The dimension of heel slab 15.55 meter width and 0.45 meter height, and the stem height is 4.78 meter. Till here, from here to here is the earth which is provided, and about 3 meter is nothing. So on this side the earth is retained. Okay, this is how the cross section and longitudinal section is to be drawn for the cantilever retaining wall. So this is for the today's class, and it completes the design. All are requested to go through the design, as we will shortly have an assignment on this. Thank you.